Clear for you people?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So last lecture we have seen the strength concept. Okay. In strength concept, I have told you, okay, that when you are going to apply the load to the tendon, suppose take this case, okay, when you are going to apply the force to the tendon with tendon placed with some eccentricity E, the P force, which is the tendon tension in the tendon, that we are going to consider as a P force. So here you can see the P force acting on the tendon. Okay. And second thing, when now consider this beam is raised on the ground and you are going to stress this tendon, your force is going to apply. There is no external load. Okay. So there is no movement of the, no stresses on the concrete. This beam is not going to bend. Okay. So what happened when you are going to place, now this case number three, when you are going to place the beam not on a ground, okay, and when you are going to apply the external load on the beam, in that case there is a stresses in a concrete, okay, and the line of stresses in a concrete, that we are going to call as a C force. So here you can see C force, which is a compressive force acting on the concrete. Okay, so last lecture we have seen P line and C line. So what is P line here? So P line is P force, which is in the tension in the tendon. And what is C line? C is a force, which is a compression force acting on the concrete. Okay. So this point is clear to people, I think. P force and C force. Now you can see here, when beam is subjected on an external load, here I can show you the external load. When beam is subjected with the external load, okay, due to this tendon here, you can see the tension line, tendon is placed here. Okay, so if tendon is placed here, this will going to show the P line. Okay, and due to the external load, C line you can see here. So this is a C line. This is P line and this is C line. Now C line, the moment when you are going to put the external load on the beam, earlier when there is a no load on a beam, P line and C line coincide to each other. But the moment when you are going to apply the external load on beam, in that case, the C line is going to shift from P line. Okay. And that shift we are going to call it as a small a. So this is shift small a. Okay, and A is shift of C line from P line, just I told you. And how you are going to get this A value, that shift you are going to get by using simple formula M by P. Okay, this is movement on the beam and this is pre-stressing force. So if you know the movement on the beam total and the pre-stressing force, you can get shift. And how we are going to calculate the extreme stresses in a concrete. So extreme stresses in concrete, we are going to calculate by using formula direct stresses. We are going to calculate, and then we are going to calculate bending stresses, that bending stresses due to this eccentricity. Okay. This E is eccentricity of C line from P line, sorry, from central axis. Okay. So we are going to see now what the problem and in how we are going to get the stresses by using strength concept that we are going to see. Already in last lecture we have seen one problem. Now today we are going to see one more problem. So this is a problem. Whether problem is visible to you people, you can see the screen. Whether screen is visible to you people. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you can see here a pre-stressed concrete beam 400 by 600 mm in section has a span of 6 meter and is subjected to a uniformly distributed load 16 kN per meter including the self weight. So this is 16 kN per meter UDL including self weight of the beam. The pre-stressing tendon are located at the lower third point and provide an effective pre-stressing force of 960 kN. So determine the extreme stresses at midspan of the section. So here we have to calculate the extreme stresses at midspan of the section. So first required thing to solve this problem to get the stresses, we people know that we have to get the cross section area of the beam. So cross section of the area beam 400 by 600. So it is 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 mm square. We have to calculate section modulus also. Section modulus Z is equal to BD square by 6. So that value will 4.4 into 10 raised to 7 mm cube. And next bending moment, beam is simply supported. So WL square by 8 will be the maximum moment. So W they have given including self weight of beam is 16 kN per meter. Into L square is a length square. Beam length 6 meter they have given. Here span by 8. So that moment is 72 kN meter. Pre-stressing force they have given 916 kN. And eccentricity they have given 100 mm. Okay. The tendon is placed at 100 mm distance. So next is we have to solve this problem by using strength concept. So the screen is visible to people. So you can see here, we have to solve the problem by using strength concept. So for strength concept, we require shift of the C line from P line. So already I have told you how you are going to get value of A. So value of A, this shift you are going to calculate by using this formula M by P. Okay. So here, if I'm going to use the value M by P, moment we have calculated 72. Okay. And P is force here, 960 into 10 raised to 3. Pre-stressing force. So this total will be 75 mm. Okay. Shift. And the eccentricity of C line, that E dash we are going to consider, E they have given 100. So 100 minus A, that, so that shift of that eccentricity from C line, eccentricity of C line from that central axis will be 25 mm below the central axis. Okay. So this is how we have got the value of E dash. That is eccentricity of C line. Okay. Hello, whether I'm audible to people?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ek wala sakan na, how you got the eccentricity value? 100 minus 75. See, they have given the eccentricity E. This eccentricity E is the distance of tendon from the central axis. Central axis distance. And the shift between the tendon and the P line and C line is 75 mm. So we want to get the eccentricity of C line, mean we want get the distance of C line from the central axis. So that value will be 25 mm. Okay. So after getting eccentricity, next thing we have to calculate the stresses. So stresses P by A minus plus P into E, E dash by Z, because of that eccentricity is downward side. Okay, that P line is going to shift downward to the central axis. The tension will be at top and compression will be at bottom. So that's why we have to write a formula like this. And we have to calculate the stresses at top fiber. So P by A minus P into E dash by Z. So we have to put the respective values here. That pre-stressing force P, eccentricity here, area, cross-sectional area of the beam and section modulus of the beam. So we will get the values like this. Sigma T, that is stresses at top fiber of the beam, is 3 Newton per mm square. And same way, stress at the bottom fiber of the beam, that P by A plus here because of the compression. So after putting this value P by A and P into E dash here, we will get the sigma B at bottom stresses 5 Newton per mm square. And in the form of diagram, if you are going to represent the pre-stressing force, the stresses here. So 4 by 600 is the section. So direct stresses here, we have calculated P by A. So 4 Newton per mm square, positive, and the bending stress is negative at top, P into E dash by Z, P into E dash by Z. So that value will be 1 newton per mm square. So combination of these two stresses is P by A minus PE, P into E dash divided by Z. And at bottom, it will be the positive because of compression. So if you are going to add direct stresses and bending stresses, the combined stresses will be get you as a positive. So this is positive stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber also. So that intensity of stresses here, 3 newton per mm square and 5 newton per mm square. Okay. So this, how we have calculated the stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam.